Today marks 83 days since a seismic crisis began on and adjacent to Greece's famed island of Santorini. This crisis led to more than 25,000 earthquakes rapidly striking in a broad region between the islands of Santorini and Domorgos, which seemed to migrate further northeastward as the days progressed for a time. A state of emergency was subsequently declared on multiple islands, and more than 80% of Santorini's population left temporarily, due in part to the worry of more magnitude 5 range earthquakes, which had caused some minor damage to a handful of structures by that point. While it is still debated whether the seismic crisis had a volcanic or purely tectonic origin, I lean towards the former explanation, with it best being explained by the drainage of magma from a portion of the Santorini volcano's deeper magma reservoir into a lengthy dike which propagated northeastwards. And yet, seismic activity peaked on February 6th, no additional expansion of the magma dike was detected after February 11th, and after that, the rate and magnitude of earthquakes progressively decreased. In fact, the daily number of these events seemingly halved about once every 18 to 21 days after February 16th, dropping from around 200 on that day to 100 on March 6th, 50-ish on March 21st, and 25 on April 14th. If this pattern holds, and there is no reason to see why it won't, by July 20th, less than one earthquake will likely be striking every day, and it will probably be too small to feel, let alone cause damage. This drop becomes all the more telling when you solely focus on the daily number of magnitude 4 or larger earthquakes, which under very specific circumstances can cause negligible to very minor damage. With this decline, it is not a surprise that most residents have rightfully returned to Santorini, and on March 24th, the first cruise ship in more than a month docked on the island, bringing tourists. Everything is seemingly returning to normal. In fact, this story seemingly parallels three other episodes of volcanic unrest, one at the Tercera volcano in the Azores and two at Ethiopia's Fantail and Dauphin volcanoes. In a scientific community I am in that discusses volcanoes and general geology, we sort of have an inside joke that nothing ever happens, even if there is a hint that something might. And given how the vast, vast majority of magmatic intrusions fail to produce volcanic eruptions on the surface, this in-joke of a line actually is fairly accurate the vast majority of the time. In fact, here is a quick list of vaguely similar unrest episodes at world volcanoes since the decade of the 2020s began. Only two of these 11 events resulted in eruptions, both of which were due to the same deep magma supply in Iceland. In other words, this decline was always the most likely outcome, and in my opinion, Santorini and its surrounding islands are once again open for business and safe to travel to. However, that does not exclude the potential to occasionally feel a light earthquake, especially since it has been 55 days without a magnitude 4.5 or larger quake striking. In essence, the current episode of unrest at the Santorini volcano is probably over. Now, I do want to note that since April 10th that a cluster of earthquakes have struck between the eastern end of Santorini and the western end of Anafi Island. While these earthquakes do not seemingly align with the presence of known regional faults, I interpret these events to still be purely tectonic in origin, just being triggered by ground deformation related to the now solidifying magma dike intrusion northeast of Santorini Island. Today's video was not made to signal any new worrying seismic or volcanic unrest at Santorini, but rather give everyone an update on the declining situation since I have not discussed this complex in more than a month after giving several updates a week for a time. As a final note, I would like to thank my new YouTube channel member T. Parrish for supporting my work.